Thank you. Good evening, everybody. My name is Russ Johnson. I'm Director of Jazz Studies here at Parkside. Thank you so much for being here. Welcome to Jazz Week. It's my favorite week of the year, as you can imagine. For those of you who have never been here before, we have a series of events out throughout this week that is really quite incredible. We have artists that are known internationally that are here on the Parkside campus pretty much every night. And it's something that I take great pride in. We created this, I think this is our 11th year. We missed one of COVID during COVID. So I think this is our 11th year of doing this. And it's an amazing opportunity for our students as well as the community at large. We will have our group play. John Irabagon's going to play. And they're going to do a, roughly an hour set, and then we're going to open up the floor for a Q&A, question and answer with the artists. And that's, and I encourage you all to stay. If you have to leave, feel free. If you want to stay, it'd be great to have you stay. The floor is open for you to ask these amazing musicians whatever you'd like to ask. You know, what, how they create a career, what they had for breakfast in the morning, you can ask them whatever you'd like to ask. I would, since our dean is sitting right here, I want to give a huge shout out to Dean Leslie Walker. Yeah, give it up for Dean. She and the College of Arts and Humanities and the entire Parkside community has been instrumental in making this happen. We couldn't do it without their support, so we are eternally grateful. I'm eternally grateful because I get to hear all this great music and I get to see some friends, and I, you know, for my students, it's just this amazing opportunity to hear all this great music. So you're in for a real treat. Tonight we're gonna hear John Irabagon. I've known John, since 2005 when he moved to New York. We were in New York together for many years, played on each other's records. We've been friends for a long time. Incredible saxophonist, has literally played with everybody. If you go on YouTube and search John Irabagon, you're gonna find him playing with Lincoln Center Jazz Orchestra. You're gonna find him playing solo sopranino at some little bar in the Czech Republic. You're gonna find like everything. His musical taste runs the gamut. His band tonight is filled with some of, and John just moved to Chicago about a year and a half ago during the pandemic. And as soon as we had an opening here for a saxophone teacher, so I'd hit him up instantly. And so John is now our saxophone teacher, which is, we're super happy to have him. And as you hear, he's a world-class musician. He literally travels all over the world. You're gonna hear Ryan Schultz on bass trumpet. Jason, Adashevitz. I thought I would get the last name was the hard name. Jason Adashevitz on vibraphone. You're gonna hear from Clark Summers on bass, Isaiah Spencer on drums. Please help me welcome the John Irabagon Quintet.
On bass trumpet. Has anyone ever seen a bass trumpet before? All right, yeah, a couple. All right. this guy on vibraphone. I played with Jason when I was 14. He got me my very first gig I ever did.
And I bought you your first real book, too, right?
He bought me my first real book, which I still use.
Yeah, you still owe me for that, too, right?
Yeah. This is Jason Adashevitz on vibraphone. Clark Summers on acoustic bass. Clark Summers on acoustic. And the one and only Isaiah Spencer on drums. John Irabagon on saxophone. Thank you. I don't know what Russ was saying earlier because we were back there, but I've known when I moved to New York in 2001, Russ was one of the first musicians that I met.
I said 2005.
Oh, well, it was 2001 for me, but whatever. Getting old, yeah, my memory's going, yeah. And so it's just an honor to be here at Parkside working with him and everything. So thank you for being here. We're excited to play. We're going to play a series of new music that I've written in the last year or two, influenced by a lot of people I know. So this song is dedicated to Dexter Gordon, and it's called Midnight Runner.
Thank you. Thank you.
song. Like, where is it? So I looked for all the music boxes in my house and realized I didn't own any music boxes. Then I asked all my family if they had any music boxes and none of them had. So then I just decided to call the song my own. So it's called the Music Box Song. And if you, any of you know that song from anywhere and it's not mine, please come up afterwards and let me know. This next song is dedicated to the great novelist David Foster Wallace. And it's called Greebles.
Thank you. Thank you.
so much. We've got a couple more for you. Are there any grandparents out in the house today? Oh, grandparents, a couple? As a new father of a 4-year-old and a 15-month-old, we thank all the grandparents out there. Any help you can give us, it's only necessary. So my second one does not sleep well, and first year of her life was crazy. So I tried to write this lullaby to get her to sleep. And it didn't work, but this song is cool. So this is called Prayer for Ryomi.
Thank you.
Casey Anishevitz on vibraphone. Casey Anishevitz on vibraphone. It's Ryan Schultz on bass trumpet. Clark Summers on the bass. Clark Summers on the bass. Isaiah Spencer on the drums. There he is. And I'm John Irabagon on saxophone. Thanks for being here. Thanks for listening. Thank you. We've got one more for you. Oh man, it's such an honor to play here and open up the festival. So thanks for having us. Thanks to Parkside, thanks to Russ Johnson and everybody here. We're gonna close with this one last song called Sprites.
Thank you. All right.